Lectures 4, to add controls to the form. Lectures plan, to add first questions, to add controls to form. First questions, to add controls to form. In this step, you add controls such as a picture box control and checkbox control to your form. You then add buttons to your form. Step 1. Go to the Toolbox tab, located in the left side of the Visual Studio IDE, and expand the Common Controls group. This shows the most common controls that you see on forms. Step 2. Choose the Table Layout Panel control on the form. To verify that the Table Layout Panel is selected, make sure that its name appears in the drop-down list box at the top of the Properties windows. You can also choose form controls by using the drop-down list box at the top of the Properties windows. Choosing a control this way can often be easier than choosing a tiny control with a mouse. Step 3. Double-click the picture box item to add a picture box control to your form. Because the Table Layout panel is docked to fill your form, the IDE adds the picture box control to the first empty cell, the upper left corner. Picture 4.1, picture box control on the form. Step 4. Choose the new picture box control to select it, and then choose the black triangle and the new picture box control to display its tasks list, as shown in the following pictures. Pictures 4.2, picture box tasks. Note, if you accidentally add the wrong type of control to your table layout panel, you can delete it. Right-click the control and then choose Delete on its context menu. You can also remove control from the form by using the menu bar. On the menu bar, choose Edit Undo or Edit Delete. Step 5. Choose the DOSC is parent container link. This automatically sets the picture box docs property to fill. To see this, choose the picture box control. To select it, go to the properties windows and be sure that the doc property is set to fill. First pictures properties windows doc to fill. Second pictures, the picture box fill the cell of container table layout component. Step 6. Make the picture box span both columns by changing its column span property. Choose the picture box control and set it column span property to first picture column span 2. Else then the picture box is empty, you want to show an empty frame. Set its border style property fixed 3D. Second pictures border style fixed 3D. Note, if you don't see a column span property for your picture box, then it's likely that the picture box was added to the form rather than the table layout panel. To fix this, choose the picture box, delete it, choose the table layout panel, and then add a new picture box. Step 7. Choose the table layout panel on the form and then add a checkbox control to the form. Double click the checkbox item in the toolbox to add a new checkbox control to the next free cell in the U table. Because a picture box takes up the first two cells in the table layout panel, the checkbox control is added to the lower left cell, pictures 4.3. Choose the text property and type in the word stretch as shown in the following pictures, pictures 4.4. Next, step 8. Choose the table layout panel on the form and then go to the containers group in the toolbox where you got your table layout panel control and double click the floor layout panel item to add a new control to the last cell in the picture box, bottom right. Then dock the floor layout panel in the table layout panel either by choosing docks is parent container of the floor layout panel's black triangle task list or by setting the floor layout panel's dock property to fill. Picture 4.5 added floor layout panel control. Picture 4.6 the properties windows property dock and is fill. Note, a floor layout panel is a container that arrange or the control is neat row in the order. When you resize a floor layout panel, if it has room to lower out all of its control in a single row, it does that. Otherwise, it arranges them is in line one on top of the other. You will use a floor layout panel to hold four buttons. If the buttons arrange one on top another when added, be sure that the floor layout panel is selected before adding the buttons. Also, it was started early that each cell can hold only one control. The lower right cell of the table layout panel has you four button controls. This is because you can pad a control in a cell that holds other controls. That kind of control is called a container and the floor layout panel is a container. Pictures 4.10 four buttons components on the form. Button 1, button 2, button 3, button 4. Now to add buttons component to form. Step 1. Choose the new floor layout panel that you added. Go to Common Controls in the toolbox and double click the button item to add a button control called button 1 to your floor layout panel. Repeat to add another button. The ID determines that there is already a button called button 1 and calls the next one button 2. Step 2. Typically, you add the other buttons using the toolbox. This time choose button 2 and then on the menu bar choose edit copy. On the menu bar choose edit paste to paste a copy of your button. Now paste it again. The ID has now added button 3 and button 4 to the floor layout panel. Toolbox and component button. Note, you can copy and paste any control, the ID names and places the new controls in a logical manner. If you paste a control into a container, the ID chooses the next logical space for the placement. Step 3. Choose the first button and set its text property to show a pictures. First buttons. Then set the text properties of the next three buttons. Second button to clear the picture. Third button, set the background color. And the fourth button, close. Step 4. The next step is to size the buttons and arrange them so they align to the right side of the panel. Choose the flow layout panel and look at its flow direction property. Change it so it's set to right to left. As soon as you do, the buttons should align themselves to the right side of the cell and reserve this order so that the show a picture button is on the right. Step 5. Choose the close button to select it. Hold down the Ctrl key and choose the other three buttons so that they are all selected. While all the buttons are selected, go to the properties window and scroll up to the auto size property. This property tells the button to automatically resize itself to fit all of its text. Set it to true. Your buttons should now be sized properly and be in the right order. As long as all four buttons are selected, you can change all four auto size properties at the same time. The following pictures show the four buttons. Pictures 4.7, picture viewers with four buttons. Properties window, after size property is true. Step 6. Now run your program again to see your newly laid out form. Choosing the buttons and the checkbox doesn't do anything it, but it will work soon. Pictures 4.8, the application started for the execution. Thank you for your attention. Self-test questions, 4 questions. Reference.